Zelensky was born in the seaside city of Odessa in the Ukraine and came to the US when he was still a teenager. He's the recipient of many prestigious literary awards, including a Whiting Writers Award, a Ruth Lilly Poetry Fellowship, and a Lannan Foundation Literary Fellowship. He writes and publishes his work both in Russian and in English, and his work has been translated into over 20 languages, including Spanish, French, Dutch, Bengali, Persian, and Chinese. He's also an editor and a translator. He edited, together with Susan Harris, the Echo Anthology of International Poetry, and he has translated into English, together with Jean Valentine, Dark Elderberry Branch, poems by Marina Tetsvaeva, and together with poet Polina Barshkova, two of her books, This Lamentable City and Traveling Musicians. In addition, Ilya co-founded, in the late 1990s, Poets for Peace, an organization that sponsors poetry readings in the US and abroad in support of relief organizations such as Doctors Without Borders and Survivors International. Ilya is also a lawyer and worked some years ago now as a law clerk at the National Immigration Law Center and at Bay Area Legal Aid, helping impoverished and homeless people with their legal difficulties. He currently teaches contemporary world poetry and literary translation and creative writing at San Diego State University. Two. In the poems of Ilya Kaminsky, everything happens. Everything that is unspeakably human, everything that is unspeakably exquisite and unspeakably joyous, everything that is unspeakably brutal and unspeakably heartbreaking, everything that is unspeakably intimate and unspeakably vivid. The poems are riddled with unforgettable images. Each hold a wondrous complexity and almost transient depth. Each give way to unforeseen transformation after unforeseen transformation. For example, the number of birds in a neighbor's backyard become a phone number. Words spoken in the dead of winter turn into icicles that are red in the air. Marina Tetsvaeva, as a brand new widow, just home from her husband's funeral, walks barefoot in the snow. And an evening sleeps inside Aunt Rose's shoulder, her shoulder rounded by sleep. This is how the immaterial engages with the material, how the material engages with the immaterial. And the poems are made as if of movement. In a poem called My Mother's Tango, there's so much movement, the opposite happens. She speaks of soups, she's of their telling. Between the regiments of saucers and towels. She moves so fast, she's motionless, opening and closing doors. In case you haven't already sensed it, the poems themselves embody the dancing that lives in the title of Ilya's extraordinary book, Dancing in Odessa. When reading it, I'm reminded of what Italo Calvino once said, that literature remains alive only if we set ourselves immeasurable goals, far beyond all hope of achievement. Ilya Kaminsky's poems are both intensely lyrical as well as ethereal. They are urgent testaments to having again and again achieved such immeasurable goals. Please help me welcome my good friend Ilya.
Wonderful conference. It's a pleasure to be here this week. There are thank you for your beautiful poems. And I also want to thank all the students with whom I work today. It was a pleasure. Actually, it's very kind to help me out. I speak with a heavy accent, as you have noticed by now. So hopefully you can follow along with the read. Okay? Lovely. Well, the first one I believe is called Mother's Prayer. Are you guys okay? More or less? do something?
Yeah.
You're doing something. One eye, left side.
Yeah.
Always. It's called Other Prayer. If I speak further that, I must leave this animal, my body. I must write the same poem over and over from empty page in the white flag of this land. If I speak further, I must walk on the edge of myself. I must leave on a blind man to run through the woods without touch. Yes, I live. I can cross the streets, asking what do you think? I can dance in my sleep and laugh in front of the mirror. Even sleep is a prayer, Lord. I will praise your madness and in a language that minds, because music that makes us music in which we move. For whatever I say is a kind of teaching eye. Darkest days, master days. Next few poems are from a sequence called Dancing in a Piazza. I believe the next one will be played in the Blaffa. Yeah, but you pray the Blaffa. But it is bound and straight in the city that belongs to no nation, but all the nations of wind. She spoke the speech of spoken dreams. For years traveling, she spoke my artworks, composing odes to barbershops, drugstores. Her soul, walking on to feed this soul or no soul, a child's allowance. She loved three musicians and news of my grandfather, composing lectures on the supply and demand of clouds in our country. The steady player, human enemy of the people. He ran after a train with tomatoes in his coat and danced naked on a table in front of her eyes. He was shy. And my grandmother, raided by the public prosecutor, who stuck his pen, her vagina, the pen which tied people up for 20 years. What a secret history. A fact. One man's silence. This. As we dance, from far, present the doctor, and the persecutor, my family, the people of ideas, who is expressed on my naive and child, all of words, and so far and fires, the trials and eyes, position and times.
The next one is called Maestro.
What is memory? What makes the body glow? And at the locket in Moldova, when the school is bombed, when the schools are bombed, serious is for me. I'm anxious now, and I feel my mind swayed. The screaming girls, 347 voices in the story of a doctor Thaden. His hand trumpet under a wolf, he dreamed of a man nearby Shavishmas. I don't want to die, I have written such a. He touches her mother, the blind man reading lips, and yells, shut up, I am near the window, I'm asking for her. Speak. You cannot stop speaking. It's the dark of Rome Chopin, he speaks to them to calm them, a doctor, yes, whatever window frame his life. Outside, the menace grew, clouds passed and we. What's there? A doctor visited her of a bird on his tractor. Since his granddaughter cheekbone is no longer her cheekbone is with surgical precision, teaches suffering and grace. Today's pass, he shuts in his window, there is no wind. But the guest approaches, he speaks of Chopin, Chopin. The girl of his hands, near the stage he stood. In my dream he stands. Feeding bread to pigeons, surrounded by pigeons, doors on his heart, his shoulders, his traps, you don't understand the zoom. He's breathing, he starts to sleep.
sees, sleeps, dreams, no, touches. Let's make a sticker next one, I think. The one after that is called my Yahweh. The next one is called my mother's tongue. My mother's tongue. It's a slightly happier one. I now see her windows open in the rain, land in the windows. She rides her white pony for my birthday, a white pony on the seventh floor. And where we begin on the balcony, the pony naked on the balcony for my Elvix, yes. That's the center of my life, my mother dance, yes, yes. As in childhood, my mother has to describe the stages of my happiness. She speaks of soups, she eats of their tail. Between the regiments of sauces and towels, she moves so fast, she's motionless. Open and closing doors. But what was happening? A pond and a mountain. My mother's past a clock, she wore on her shoulder. I ran up through the afternoon to see her 60. Caught in a foreign language, young, not young, my mother. Gallops a pony on a seventh floor. She becomes a stranger, an axe, a sign, opens for a shadow, chance for a thought. The next one is a little lovely, called American Tourist. Are you awake? American Tourist. In a city made of secrets, we dance it on a rooftop by hands and the whole subtracting days from there, this woman's hand comes to my days of atonement. Her lover leaves the formal bodies of her face. We were made in love, although her story is the issue of her end. Her happiness is mine, yes, but only the smallest curse. She asks me to pray. To bow to my Jerusalem, we bow to the left, I saw two bakeries, a true store, the smell of hay, smell of horses, and hay. But Moses broke the sacred tablets on Sinai, the rich picked the pieces, carved with adultery and kill, and that the fool got only no, no, no. I kissed the back of her man, and then this woman, who's forgetting, is a blood against forgetting, naked in her galoshes, she falls to me in her head. Both, she says, all that is musical in us is memory, but I did not know English, I dance it sitting down, she straightened and bent and straightened, a tremble of music, a sample in her hand. And the next little poem is called Dancing in Odessa. We live in north of the future. It's over, it led us with a child's signature, a raspberry, a patch of sky. My grandmother's new tomatoes from her balcony, she put in imagination like a blanket over my head. I paint my mother's face. She understood loneliness, hid the dead and the earth like partisans. Then I don't drive fast. I come to the schools. My mother danced triple in the past with speeches, casseroles, and this my doctor laughed at his granddaughter, touching my eyelid, I peek in the back of her knee. I see it rambling, I watch it sailing. And my classmate invited 20 names for Duke, he was an angel, he had no name, we wrestled, yes. My grandpa's for the German tent and the doctors, I kept a suitcase full of breakfast for him. The secret rambling, I watched it say, at night, I walked to each but yes, believe it, yes, don't say it was a dream. It's a local park, my father, took a handful of snow, put it in my mouth, and some began a tinder age, whitening their bodies. Mother, father, dancing, moving, and the darkness spoke behind them. It was April, The sun washes the balcony, say, provides it all the stories, the light that she said by my time. Little boy, go to the city. It's not me.
Okay, so, are you tired yet?
Nope.
Okay, once the writers got out of the system, their childhood, they started to look out, well, what is it that I really care about? And most of them really cared about other writers. Simply because they give you the forms of existence you didn't know you had. Like, Malena's poems give you the forms of existence I didn't know I had. The next one I'm going to read is a longer elegy, a longer poem for a great Russian poet, Osip Mandelstam. For those of you who do not know who he was, you can go to the library and find out. All you need to know for the purpose of this poem is that Mandelstam was a great Russian poet who happened to write a poem against the government. It happened to be Joseph Stalin's government. Time happened to be 1930s, and the place was Soviet Union, which means that he was sent into exile when he died, and his wife, Nadezhda, was also sent in a different kind of place, but she survived. That's all you need to know. The poem was both in verse and prose, and it was sometimes spoken in voices that was in the name of Mandelstam. Okay? Should we get the same page? More or less. Music of Humana. Miniature prose of Mandelstam. Music of Humana. A mother Nautilus. Such a house never adorned. While his widow searched across one sixth of the old surface, flushing the source from with his son spread out and flank, memorized him by night with gifts, till I found by fears to search one to me. While there is still some light on the page, he escapes in a tragedy's court with his wife, and the clothes smell satisfied. And the dog runs after them, licking the earth where they bolted on them. In a peach, on a stair, above the door, he will show her the way to silence. They will leave the area, talking to itself, making love. They turn off the lights, but the neighbor has been on course, and he forges. That's the night it is. It is the 1930s. Петербург is a frozen trip, the cathedral's cafe, down Невский проспект, they move, and the new state sticks its wings. The man in Crimea, he got with Tukatovich, liberals, and placed some stricter on judgment day. If you asked it, whether you understood the poet, was Mandelstam, say no, how to fight. I'm reading aloud the book of my life on earth and on fire. I lie and pray for it. In a pinch of sausages, the steel mark as the men raise their cup, the bow in a white shirt, I dip my finger in the swings. Mother, what is behind my ears, and we speak of parents, and that I'll not come true, which is to say, if I laugh. Gustav was a light in a trees, full of fury, August with a hurt, with a lunch, the death was one. Now, memory, with some beer, tell the rim of the glass, you who are writing me, have what you want, a golden coin. My time to put under. The younger brother of the clouds, he walks unshaven in dark green pants. In casinos, he falls on his knees, praying happiness. His words in a floor of the skeletons of debtors. I have lied, yeah. Forged my hands, spoke of loyalty to the earth. Now there's a lover boy comes, my fingers. I escape, and I'm caught. Escape again, and I'm caught. Escape, and I'm caught. It's a sign. To see, here is a clay finger, poetry, the sound, but it is the sound. I'll see what a St. Petersburg dance like a last use with churches, shrimps, and guillotines. Our lives.
in summer 1924, was if Mandelstam wrote his young wife to St. Petersburg. Not just the words, but the French called out Major Mount. And I thought, of course he was. His real student, that's the state. For complaining he wasn't published, was he trying for supper? For Jesus Christ. Boy, he's a boy, I said. Like Carlos Hirsch prayed to himself as he falls. Yes, my life is a broken branch in a wind hit the northern ground. I'm writing now a history of snow. The lovely peasants and ships that sail across the page, but on certain afternoons, the Republic of Thoughts opens up and I grow frightened that I haven't lived, died, not enough to scratch this ecstasy. The farms, splashes of big speech. I played. Augustine, the loneliness of their syllables, while Icarus keeps falling, and Arinachmadava, for each weight binds me to the earth, and at least an exterior is breathing. The day, the daylight, yes, I live. They take Havia by the feet, I saw St. Petersburg daughters, once I learned the grammar of Gauss array and found myself for good. Thou pushed in street by your memory, suddenly corner erasing me with a sponge. I have made mistakes, yes. In bed I got buried government to my girl. And the great part of Hanshaw and all the scheme, all of us dancing high. He sat on the edge of his chair and dreamt aloud of Putinus. He composed his poems not at his desk, but in the streets of St. Petersburg. He adored the image of Jerusalem, during a part of the night under the walls of Metropolis with his tongue. But it happened to Sam. He was banging on the door. You have got to let me out. I wasn't made a priest. Once or twice in his life, a man is peeled like apples. What is life? Is a voice that splits his being down to the center we see, obscenity, he fright, mud, but there is joy of shame. There is almost more and empty prospects, they hear the bird like stretch, pray for this man who lived on bread and tomatoes, while ducks recited his poetry in each street. Yes, Count Man, July, with them together with a dread star. Lord, press his force against your violence. This story is told of a man who escaped and is captured into the prose of inks. After making love, he sits up in the kitchen floor, eyes wide open. Speaks of the Lord emptiness in whose image he are made. He's out of work, I won't see the river endured. He's kissing his wife's neck, so the skin of her belly tightens. What a thing of a boy, lay syllables with his tongue under a woman's skin. Thus, a lion's certain time of silence. Nadjeta, his wife, looks up from the page and speaks. Osip, Akhmatova, and I were sitting together when suddenly Mandelstam noticed this joy. Several little girls ran past us, emerging in themselves to behold us. The first one stopped and patiently asked, where is the last horse? I grabbed Mandelstam by his hand to prevent him from joy, and Akhmatova, to sense in danger, wishing it. Do not run away from us. You're out, last. Nadjeta continues to speak. As I die, I walk barefoot across my country. Here Peter builds the strongest salad to tractors, break it to centaurs, and gallops through plains. Beach. At 23, believe in the cocoon, the butterflies are made. As he puts his fingers in the fire, he gets up early, walking around and gets temple sweat slowly. Prayers fall into the room. Mother watching him from the window as he stumbles over
space from underneath the dark and clarity.
That's my distance speaks. Strength, your knowledge, life, her hands are quiet. Thought is in silence.
Oh, God of vapor, of ice, and of chill, and your scale of good and evil,
with a blade, a thorn. The debtor continues to swim.
But my husband returned from Verona, in his mouth he hid a silver spoon. In his dreams, down Yachty Prospect, the dictator ran like a wolf after his burst, a wolf with sleep in its eyes. He believed it's a human being. Couldn't you himself of Petersburg? He retired by heart phone numbers of the dead.
Oh, what he told in a low voice.
The unspoken voice became the greatest of violence when he slapped it on stones the face.
It was gone. And I took my husband. Each word disappeared in the book.
They watched him as he spoke, the vows had dispersed.
And they said, you must leave him alone.
For the lady behind his back, the stones circle all by themselves.
On the last page of the spoon, was had regardless to the middle of his cheeks. We were not in a long breath in the street, but we were not in a bar I don't remember. We turned at the Gogol Boulevard and Osip said, I'm ready for death. At his arrest, they were searching for poems of organs of love. We sat in one room, and the other side of a ball at neighbors, a Hawaiian guitar was playing. In my presence, the investigator found the ball and showed it to Osip. He nodded slightly, taking the grief, he kissed it. He went right away at 7, 8, 9. At the end of each year,
Mandelstam stands with a cloud of earth, living beings that the passes by, you will recognize him alone.
He hates that castle,
Lord, all my ghost is tapping in your verse, you're not human, you're gorgeous.
But what harmony
was it traveling and unraveling, not yet the saints of snowfall and cipher?
She has the voice of the unchained and so her flesh. Not yet, oh yes, and no, are you?
She dances its core, tucked between her thighs, and the light is stretching.
In a shrimp's for cold, he's making love to her ear, like his brothers, living days, and the Nazi's traveling across her beach and touching furniture,
a small propeller in his hand.
Don't speak. Outside, a boy, listen again to the tree, a beggar, curse. At his cut,
that summer, 1938, the walls were high.
The thumping
against the city slaps the city in a letter to say yes
to the power. At the end of each vision, she ran her feet, smell. She opened her body, lay in his stomach. We will meet in Petersburg. By the sun.
I'm just going to read one quick poem and I'll be out of your hair because I need to be out of your hair. So let's go. You know, I make a poem in a book. I actually have an epigraph, which is true. In 1992, somebody said, you don't die in a boat, some other do it, yes, whatever that means. So, an envoy.
What ties me to the soul? In Massachusetts, the birds force themselves into my life. The sea repeats itself, repeats, repeats. I bless the boat from Yonkers
to our ears, and bless each passage, his bones, his gems. But the sky inside is fine. The sky, my maiden, the sky, my country. A blessed continent of gulls, the arbor wind of the Lord, and the wind, my master, the sun's joy, a foe and spies. Bless my woman's brows, her reeds, and the sun, bless her round, it's a foretold, her bless the land, by Chavino, my life, you can find us, she's a woman dancing with her eyes closed, and I'm a man arguing with this woman, I'm a nice. Babe, Jay, Lord Diaz, what you have of late?